a lot of people resort to racial profiling in order to protect their investment, basically just because they want to ensure that they are able to collect rent, they're able to ensure that their property remains in good condition. And this is a problem that needs to be addressed. So landlord-tenant tribunal will be able to adjudicate problems that both landlord and tenants face, including unpaid rent, but also problems that the tenant may face on their side, like a landlord who refused to repair a broken toilet, a landlord who refused to repair a leaky roof. And these grouses that both landlord and tenants face should not have to go through lengthy court processes, which is the only legal resort that people have today. The perception is that Indians don't pay rent on time, and Indians or don't pay rent at all. And this perception is very widespread. I moved from Subang Jaya to PJ in 2015. So in that first hunt for houses, that was the problem I faced, where if I were to make the call, then all properties seem to be already rented out and not available. But if my assistant Vivian, who's a Chinese lady, makes the calls, then viewing is available. And from that, I found my first place. Ironically, the landlord was an Indian. This is the real problems that I have gone through myself, and a lot of Indians have gone through. And a lot of landlords will then tell their side of the story that, you know, they've been burnt many times. So landlords have gone through like 6 months rental not paid, 3 months rental not paid, or rent always comes in late. So a lot of landlords, regardless of race, have been burnt. And in fact, a lot of Indian landlords also discriminate against Indians, not just Chinese and Malay landlords. And this is the story that goes around. And so people build on people's experiences and start to discriminate. And one thing that the tribunal can quickly solve is this issue of not paying rent. And if you don't pay rent today, quite frankly, there's really not much the landlord can do to you. So unless the landlord hires a lawyer, takes out another 5,000-6,000 ringgit to initiate a court case against you to enforce the fact that you have not paid rent, there's really not much else the landlord can do or resort to gangsterism. So I think many landlords don't want to resort to gangsterism, don't want to resort to having to spend 5,000-6,000 ringgit hiring a lawyer. So the safer thing is, if you're renting a property for like 1,500 ringgit a month, 1,200 ringgit a month, why go through that hassle? Just, you know, racially profile your tenants to what you believe will pay rent. And that is the biggest crux. This notion of will they pay rent? That's 80 to 90% of the problem. If there's a mechanism for landlords to ensure that they get their rent, or if they don't get their rent within 7 days, they can solve this problem through a tribunal, that will definitely ease a lot of people's opinions on renting out to everyone. And in fact, when you drive the risk down for landlords, you also drive the rent down. And when you help landlords, you know, do this, then good tenants get it better, because then there's less issues on that part now, you know, discrimination on the basis of profiling. So that's how I believe this can significantly help. It will not solve 100% of the problem, and there are people with true prejudice in their hearts, and that one is a more difficult problem to solve. But on a very practical level, this could probably solve at least 80% of the discrimination when it comes to advertising properties for rent. This is a mechanism that I believe is timely. It's something that's proven to be effective around the world, and it's timely that Malaysia also embarks on it. So I urge KPKT to do this in the interest of both landlords and tenants.